हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम शिवाजी वाल्के। इन टुडे सेशन ऑफ कमोडिटी मार्केट वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट रेगुलेटरी मैकेनिज्म फॉर कमोडिटी एक्सचेंज मार्केट इन इंडिया और वेरियस रेगुलेशंस अथॉरिटीज और कमीशंस और बॉडीज और बोर्ड्स विच आर कंट्रोलिंग द कमोडिटी एक्सचेंज मार्केट इन इंडिया। सो फॉर दिस पर्पज वी हैव टू ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस। फर्स्ट FMC और फॉरवर्ड मार्केट कमीशन, FMC फॉरवर्ड मार्केट कमीशन। द सेकेंड वन दैट इज सिक्योरिटी एक्सचेंज बोर्ड ऑफ इंडिया और SEBI, सिक्योरिटी एक्सचेंज बोर्ड ऑफ इंडिया। सो विल बिगिन विथ व्हाट इज एन FMC। सो FMC वॉज एस्टैब्लिश इन द ईयर ऑफ 1953 अंडर द सेक्शन 3 ऑफ Forward Contract and Regulation Act 1952 and has executive as a well advisory functions. So this FMC was established in the year of September 1953 under the Section 3 of Forward Contract Regulation Act 1952 and working as mainly executive and advisory function for the commodity exchange or forward markets. Then this FMC was concerned about the various market functions like first one, to give advice to the central government in respect of recognizations or withdrawal of recognition from any associations in respect of any other matter arising out the administration of Forward Contract Regulation Act 1952. So it gives the advice to the central government regarding the recognizations or withdrawal of recognizations from association from the various institutions or various financial institutions. Then second one, to keep forward markets under the observations and to take such actions relation to the them. So this forward market commissions keep watch on the forward markets and taking care of the all actions or all operations which are going to perform in a forward markets. Then to collect and whenever the commissions thinks it is necessary to the publish information regarding the trading conditions in respect of goods. So this FMC was collecting information related to the goods or various commodities which are traded in a commodity exchange markets. And they are also publishing that informations or terms and conditions related to the trading of the commodities in various things. Then, to the continuation of functions, to make recommendations generally with the view to improve the organizations and working of forward markets. So, it make for recommendations and improving the organizations and working for forward markets. So it provide the guidance or it provide the advice to the various forward markets for proper working. Then to withdraw the attention of government to the various development that are taking place in the different forward market with the suitable recommendations. Then it also draw the attention of the government for the purpose of development in a forward market or development in a exchange markets. So basically it was representing these forward markets. Then to submit periodical reports to the government on the operation of act on the working of the forward markets. Then it was also submitting the various periodical reports or the progress of the forward markets to the governments. Then to inspect account of recognized associations generally with the view of improving the organizations and working forward markets. So it inspect the account of the various recognized associations or the various associations bodies, okay, like the various financial institutions or the various commercial banks or the various foreign banks. So it keep watch or it inspect the various associations of the commodity exchange. Then next one, that is SEBI. Now, this FMC was worked during the 1953 to 2015. After that one, this FMC was merged with an SEBI, that is Security Exchange Board of India. Okay, now we'll start with what is an SEBI. So SEBI stands for Security Exchange Board of India. Then SEBI was established in the year of 1988. Primary role of this SEBI was to observe the market, but the SEBI had no power to control anything. It was on non-statutory bodies. So this SEBI was established in the year of 1988, but that times it having no power to regulate the exchange market or to regulate the securities markets. Then to give the powers, Union Government of India passed SEBI Act in the year of 1992, and on 12 April 1992 SEBI become a autonomous bodies or statutory bodies for within statutory body for controlling the various exchange market or the securities markets. Okay, the SEBI was established in the year of 1988, but that time it don't have any power to control the security markets. But after that, in the year of 1992, by SEBI Act, it received the powers, and from that period onwards, the SEBI is an autonomous organizations or the one of the statutory bodies or with an special power for the purpose of controlling the securities markets. Then what is an organization structure of this SEBI? So SEBI concern one chairperson, which is appointed by the Government of India. Then two members are the officer from the Union Finance Ministries. Then one member from RBI. Then five members are appointed by the Union Government of India. Out of these five, three are whole time or full time members. Okay, so this is an organization structure for the SEBI. It concerns one chairperson, which is appointed by the Government of India. Then two members from the Union Ministry of Finance. Then one member from RBIs. Then five members from the Union Governments, which are appointed by the Union Government. Out of that five, three are the whole time or full time members. Then what is an objectives or main motto of this SEBI? So first one, to provide transparent and healthy platforms for corporates to raise the fund from the financial markets. So basically, when it was started, the times the purpose of this SEBI was to provide the transparent and healthy platforms to the various corporates or the various companies or organizations for raising the funds from markets. We can say raising the firm from share markets. Then to create and enforce by law for corporates and financial intermediaries. So it create and enforce by the laws for the corporates. So it create and various laws, regulations related to the security markets for the purpose of controlling the activities of these corporates or of these various industries. Then to protect the rights of investors and ensure the safety of their investment. So it's protecting the right of investors or the right of shareholders or the right of the person who is investing in a share market or person who is investing in a various corporates by this share market way. Then listen and provide the supports from the investors and grievances. So they listens and provide the support to the investors for their various grievances or for their various doubts or queries. Then what is an role or we can say functions of SEBI? So first one, that is protective functions. Under this, SEBI perform the following functions to provide the safe and transparent environment for the investors who keep the financial market alive. So for the purpose of means in a protective functions, the SEBI perform the following functions. First one, that is prevent price riggings. Okay, prevent the price riggings in the markets. It means the unnecessary rising of the prices or the leaking of the informations from that company to another companies. Okay, or the intra trading, or we can say the under tradings. Okay, or the misuse of this financial markets. Then prohibit the insider tradings. Okay, it provide or it try to avoid the insider tradings. Then financial educations for the investors. They have also launched for the financial educations for the investor. For this purpose, they are conducting the various training programs by the help of this various commodity exchange market or various the financial institutions, like through the National Stock Exchange or through the Bombay Stock Exchange. Then it are providing the SEBI guidelines for the corporates or the for the companies who is raising the funds from the markets, and for the investor also who is investing his money in the financial institutions. Then regulatory functions. It means for regulations or for making the rules or regulations or for regulating the markets. It refers to the enforcement of SEBI by law to the financial intermediaries and corporates. Okay, various regulatories or controlling functions. SEBI has design guidelines and code of conduct that are enforced to the financial intermediaries and corporates. These SEBIs have designed the various guidelines or what to do and what not to do, or the what is an ethicals or what is an unethicals. Okay, so SEBI has designed this kind of guidelines or the limits for which this investors or the corporate has to follow. Then SEBI registers all the intermediaries, share transfer agents, trustees, and all those who are associated with a stock exchange in any manners. So this register, these corporates or these stockers or these broker persons or various brokering agencies, then the various agents or even your investor also. So it gives the registers or the it provide the register for the maintaining the documents or for the maintaining the information related to these investors through the way of by providing the DMAT account. Then various corporate who are raising the funds from their IPO, that is initial public offerings. Okay, then the various institutions, corporate institutions who are investing in a different shares, or the various financial institutions who are providing their bonds or various legal securities to the other persons. Okay, so for that purpose they have maintained the registers. Then SEBI registers and regulate the functioning of mutual funds. So nowadays this SEBI is also maintaining the register and regulating the function of these mutual funds. Okay, for mutual fund also. Now what is mutual funds? Okay, so for example, any company wants, let's say 1,100 CR rupees for their development activities, and as one individual person or any individual person, he is not able to invest this much amounts. Okay, so group of people comes together and they invest in this companies or in this institutions. Okay, by giving their 20 CR, they are making that 100 CR amounts. Okay, mutual fund by coming together. Okay, then various developmental functions. The developmental functions are refers to the SEBI's initiatives in which bring fresh breath and innovation in the Indian financial markets. So they are performing the various developmental functions also for the purpose of modern things in a transactions or modern things in a trading accounts. Okay, then like introduction of electronic platforms. Nowadays we can see the various electronic platforms on which the trading is done. Okay, in earlier days there need to go to the platforms and by showing some signs and symbols there the trading activities are going on. Okay, then introduction of DMAT account. Okay, what is an DMAT account? That is an dematerialized account. Okay, or if you want to invest into the securities market or in a share market, then you need this DMAT account. DMAT stand for dematerialized account. Okay, it is on same like your bank account, but in case of bank, what you are doing, that bank account just maintaining the record of your funds or your monies. Okay, but this DMAT account is referring to the transaction of your bonds or shares. Okay, how much shares you have bought or how much shares you have sold. So record maintained in a DMAT. Then introduction of discount brokerage. Okay, various discount brokerage concept also introduced into the markets. Then training and financial intermediaries, to giving the training to the various financial instrument intermediaries like the brokerage agents. Then buy and sell mutual funds directly from AMC through the brokers. So this is also possible through the development functions of the SEBIs. Then so this is about the today's sessions. Now what we learn today, today we have seen about the regulatory mechanisms or regulatory bodies who are controlling the commodity markets. Okay, so first one, 1952 ते 2015 पर्यंत आपल्याला फॉरवर्ड मार्केट कमिशन्स याच्या अंडर एक्सचेंज मार्केट किंवा कमोडिटी एक्सचेंज मार्केट कंट्रोल केलं जात होतं. ओके, 1953 ते 2015 कोण कंट्रोल करायचं? एफ एम सी. पण काय झालं 2015 ही एफ एम सी सेबीमध्ये मर्ज झालं. ओके, आता सेबी 1988 इस्टॅब्लिश झालं. ओके, त्यावेळेस त्याच्याकडे कोणतीही पॉवर नव्हते. त्याच्यानंतर 1992 त्यांनी एक सेबी ॲक्ट करून त्याचे एक स्टॅच्युटरी बॉडी तयार केली किंवा स्पेशल पॉवर दिली याला. आणि ते 1992 ते 2015 फक्त शेअर मार्केट किंवा म्युच्युअल फंड्स यालाच कंट्रोल करायचं. त्याच्यानंतर 2015 ते आता शेअर मार्केट आणि कमोडिटी एक्सचेंज मार्केट ह्या दोन्हीला पण कंट्रोल करतं. ओके, नंतर आपण पाहिलं की हे कोणत्या ॲक्टनुसार आलं, तर तो ॲक्ट आहे फॉरवर्ड कॉन्ट्रॅक्ट रेग्युलेशन ॲक्ट 1952. ओके, ह्या फॉरवर्ड मार्केट कमिशनचे मेजरली फंक्शन काय, तर गव्हर्नमेंटला ॲडवाईस देणे रिगार्डिंग द असोसिएशन्स टू द व्हेरियस इन्स्टिट्यूशन्स. ओके, देन कीप वॉच ऑन दी मार्केट्स ऑर कमोडिटी एक्सचेंज मार्केट्स. देन पब्लिश द इन्फॉर्मेशन रिगार्डिंग दी फायनान्शियल इन्स्टिट्यूशन्स ऑर द कमोडिटी एक्सचेंज ऑर द टर्म्स अँड कंडिशन्स रिलेटेड टू द कमोडिटीज. देन टू मेक अ रिकमेंडेशन्स फॉर इम्प्रूविंग द ऑर्गनायझेशन्स ऑर फॉर द इम्प्रूविंग द एक्सचेंज. देन टू ड्रॉ द अटेन्शन ऑफ गव्हर्नमेंट फॉर व्हेरियस डेव्हलपमेंट ॲक्टिव्हिटी, मीन्स फॉर द डेव्हलपमेंट ॲक्टिव्हिटीज इन अ एक्सचेंज मार्केट ऑर इन अ कमोडिटी एक्सचेंज मार्केट. देन टू सबमिट पिरियॉडिकल रिपोर्ट्स ऑर द परफॉर्मन्स रिपोर्ट टू द गव्हर्नमेंट. देन इन्स्पेक्ट अकाउंट फॉर द रिकग्नाइज्ड असोसिएशन्स. देन वी हॅव सीन वॉट इज अन सेबी. सो सेबी इज अन सिम्पली सिक्युरिटी एक्सचेंज बॉडी बोर्ड ऑफ इंडिया. ओके, इट वॉज एस्टॅब्लिश इन द इयर ऑफ 1988. देन इट रिसीव्ह द पॉवर इन द इयर ऑफ 1992 बाय द सेबी ॲक्ट. देन ऑर्गनायझेशन स्ट्रक्चर, इट इन्क्लूड वन चेअरपर्सन, देन टू मेंबर फ्रॉम युनियन फायनान्स मिनिस्ट्री, देन वन मेंबर फ्रॉम युनियन बँक ऑफ इंडियाज, देन फाईव्ह अनादर मेंबर्स अपॉइंटेड बाय द युनियन गव्हर्नमेंट. देन वॉट आर द ऑब्जेक्टिव्ह ऑर पर्पज ऑफ दिस सेबी. सो फर्स्ट वन, टू प्रोव्हाइड ट्रान्सपरंट अँड हेल्दी प्लॅटफॉर्म फॉर इन्व्हेस्टर्स. देन टू क्रिएट द व्हेरियस लॉज आर रेग्युलेशन रिलेटेड टू द सिक्युरिटी मार्केट्स. देन द प्रोटेक्ट द राईट ऑफ इन्व्हेस्टर्स. Then listen to the listen and provide the support system for the grievances of the various investors or the various corporates or various financial institutions who involved in the this security markets. Then role of SEBIs or function of SEBIs. So first one, protective functions, that is protecting the interests of investors, or we can say even corporate also. Then for this purpose they are preventing the price riggings, okay, unwanted movement. Then they providing prohibit the insider tradings, okay, by stealing the information, insider informations. Then financial education for the investors. For this purpose they have launches various MBA programs also under the observation of National Stock Exchange or the Bombay Stock Exchange. Then releasing the various SEBI guidelines for conducting the transactions. Then regulatory functions means management or regulating the action of the various exchange bodies. Okay, then we have seen the various developmental functions. Under that they have introduced these DMAT account formats, then electronic trading platforms, then your discount brokerage, then AMC systems also. Okay, so this is about the whole today's session. I hope you understand. If not, please ask me. Thank you.